I guess this would be the moment of truth or whatever. Can I annex these guys before somebody goes to war with me? Now, if it... This is thing is, like, if any single group goes to war with me, it's not so bad because they... I still got tons of vassals. But if one of them goes to war with... whatever this one is, Otomo... Yeah, if somebody goes to war with Otomo and conquers most of Otomo, that'll set me back a lot. Same if somebody goes to war with Uesugi and conquers most of Uesugi. I've got to annex both of those before either one of these thinks about attacking somebody. Hopefully that's what happens.
Thank you.
Looks like we're right about to get Otomo, and a year later we get Osege. These guys are just about ready to revolt against me. With any luck though, we'll get Otomo first. That will reduce their liberty to desire, and we can go from there. And there we go, folks. Like I said, it was very important in the beginning to grab Kai. Otherwise, the Sega could take off. But really, there was so many competitors down here with Shiba and everything like that that I wasn't too worried about them going crazy there. In the future, if you can, don't pick your mission so early, because what you should do is aim for missions that give you quick, easy prestige, because you need to keep your prestige above zero, and you can break the vassal status, and that will give you a casus belli to invade immediately, and it's easier to repair that than to sit back and slowly watch them potentially overtake you. You know what I'm saying? So always keep that as like an ace card when you're playing as Japan. So you always want to keep that there. And that's actually, I was holding on to that in case he started a war or they started a war. I would break vacillation.